Man, oh man, nothing in the world feels as good as what I'm feeling right now. It's 1:43 in the morning as I'm recording this video. It'll be up in about 8 hours, but I have finally wrapped up finishing up all of the stuff we need to do for the NHL 21 roster. It is why you're seeing some Detroit Red Wings franchise mode gameplay in the background right now, because everything has been finalized. We added all the prospects. We have 70 created players. I went through every single team from the NHL to the AHL to the ECHL to all the European leagues and the junior teams as well, edited all the potentials that I felt were necessary to change, and now it feels so good to have everything set in stone. But that's only one part of it, because we still have to record gameplay. I haven't actually recorded it yet, but it will be recorded, put onto this commentary, and then we'll go forward. But last time we spoke about the Detroit Red Wings prospects, it got quite a good reception, and I saw a lot of people saying that they enjoyed that type of content. So what we're doing here today is talking a little bit more about the SHL and our beloved Red Wings prospects that are indeed doing their thing over there. So, we have ourselves some guys to talk about, but I will make a quick disclaimer. In the previous video, we spoke about three guys, Lucas Raymond, Jonatan Berggren, and the recent signing in Vladislav Nemesnikov. Today, we're talking about two other guys, and one of the other ones that we spoke about in the previous video as well, but it is the two new guys that bring the most attention to this idea, I guess. Today, we're talking about Moritz Seider, Joe Veleno, as well as Jonatan Berggren. So, let's start off with the guy who has a little bit more star power. We'll go over with Moritz Seider, because when it comes to Moritz Seider, it's very obvious to see that he is one of the more prominent Detroit Red Wings players in the organization today. Anytime I make any video talking about Moritz Seider, you all seem to absolutely eat it up. We always get some good discussions going on in the comments about Seider. And I feel like we're gonna have the same thing with this new topic, because he has recently suited up for the Rögle BK hockey team in the SHL. And yes, this is not the Adler Mannheim in the DEL. In fact, the Adler Mannheim in the DEL actually haven't played any games, so it's understandable to see why Seider was practicing with the team in Germany, with Tim Stützle, etc. But now, because the plan is to give him playing time, he was sent over to Rögle. He suited up as a big right-handed defender to play on that unit. And in fact, if you go over here onto Reddit, there's a really good post on our Detroit Red Wings posted by Alex Force, who describes what exactly happened during Moritz Seider's first game in Sweden. There are a few clips. I'll leave a link in the description to the Reddit post so you can check out those clips and read the article itself. Seider, according to Alex Force, played really well for his first game since March, and added on top of that a completely new team. He did exactly what he did while he played for Grand Rapids, reading the play really well, joining the rush whenever he could while not being out of position, and playing with close to zero fear, meaning he never second-guessed himself and he played really smart. I think I saw him do one single mistake, which was him holding onto the puck a little too long in the D zone, which caused a forechecker to be able to poke the puck away from him, but he had a forward to back him up, so it didn't end up being a dangerous chance. He's playing over with Eric Gelinas, who is a guy who you probably recognize that name. Definitely is a guy who did have his fair share of NHL time in the past, and he's a guy whom the Rögle BK rely upon quite well, so for Seider, it's easy to understand the idea of him getting more playing time as it goes on. Later on, though, in the next game that he played, he actually got an assist, so that was very nice. He threw the puck to the goal, there was a few rebounds thrown around in front, and all of a sudden now, if you take a look at it, Moritz Seider, in two games played in the SHL, has 1 point. So obviously, that's great to see. This guy's over there, he's doing his thing with the Rögle BK, getting points, getting minutes, getting development, actually playing out there. And in fact, his D partner, Eric Gelinas, I just looked it up. The guy's at 8 points in 8 games. My gosh, he's leading the team in points as a D-man. And this is the guy whom Seider is playing with and learning a thing or two from. So that's great. Next up, though, we have Joe Veleno. He's a guy who was drafted by the Detroit Red Wings all the way back in 2018 at the end of the first round. Now, if you've followed the channel for over 2 years, you know my opinions on Joe Veleno. As a guy who's a Vancouver Canucks fan, I was very open to the idea of taking Joe Veleno where the Canucks had their first round pick, which was 7th overall. The fact that we spoke about him that highly kinda indicates my whole idea and perception towards the player that is Joe Veleno, but the Canucks got Quinn Hughes instead, which was good. It was a good pick, if I do say so myself. But Veleno did drop to the end of the first round, where the Detroit Red Wings snagged him up, and after initial reports indicating that he might be going over to the Czech Republic to play with Filip Zadina, he actually is going over to Sweden too, and he's played a game with the Malmö Redhawks. And unfortunately though, according to our friend Alex Force, Veleno was not necessarily all too comfortable out there playing on the bigger ice. He tried to make plays, but they were often just ending up in dump-ins. He does play on the right point on the second power play, which is indeed a good sign. There were a few good defensive plays, pickpocketing guys, and a few good backchecking opportunities too. He played 17 minutes in his first game, but he wasn't really used as a number one center, which is pretty understandable. I mean, the guy's like 20, so it's kind of okay for him to not be thrusted into that number one role, especially for a pro Swedish team. But another note that is made over here by Alex is that Joe Veleno, unfortunately, it looks like he's staying out there a little bit too long, which is leading to him being a little bit more tired than you would like to see. So far, he's at 2 games played, though, 0 points in the SHL, so we'll see how eventually this is able to come through. Obviously, it's a big change for a guy who has played on small ice his entire life. For Moritz Seider, it's easier, because he played his entire career in Germany before going over to Grand Rapids and then going back to big international ice. But for Veleno, there certainly will be some growing pains, so we'll see how that goes on as this story and this season continues. But we're wrapping things up with another update on Jonatan Berggren, because man, this guy just cannot stop scoring points. Again, if you have not gotten the memo yet, Berggren was taken a few picks after that Joe Veleno in the 2018 second round. Veleno was taken at the end of the first round, Berggren was taken at the start of the second round. They were literally taken 2 picks apart. Berggren has been a very good SHL point producer, and now, my gosh, he's upped his points per game. 13 points, 9 games played, 2 goals, 11 assists. He is all the way up there, not first anymore though, because Marek Hrivík from the Leksands IF has absolutely been going ballistic. But it has actually made itself out into a very nice and tight scoring race for that first overall spot in the Swedish Hockey League. Berggren had 2 points in his most recent game, and he's up here with a second place position. But as a matter of fact though, Berggren's actually a guy who probably should have a few more points, because he was on a point streak earlier on in the year that actually got cut short, because in the most previous game played, he had a goal taken away, which puts him in a weird spot, because hey, if that goal did indeed counted, he would have been 1 point away from being the number one point producer in the SHL rather than 2, and he would have increased that gap between 3rd, 4th, and 5th place, respectively. But obviously, there's nothing else new here. Jonatan Berggren's doing his thing. Jonatan Berggren is getting points, and we will catch up with this as he goes on throughout the season. Unlike Seider and Veleno, I don't really think there's an expectation for Berggren to come over to North America once the season comes back over here. But for the other two guys, Seider, Veleno, they'll probably come back. They've been loaned out to SHL clubs for this reason, and they'll probably finish off the year either in Detroit or in Grand Rapids. But for Berggren, man, this guy's got a playground in front of him right now, and it comes in the form of the entire SHL and its goaltenders. So we'll see how he is able to match up, and by the end of the year, who knows if this guy is a number one point producer in the entire league, or if he's a top 3 or a top 2 or whatever. It'd be very interesting to see that for sure, since he is only 20 years old. There's so much potential in this young guy who a lot of people didn't really notice back when he was drafted. He was just seen as another guy, but man, I'm telling you, super valuable pickup there in the second round. So talk to me in the comments what you think about Moritz Seider. He's been doing really well. It's like he never left. He's adjusted to SHL play really nicely, he's gotten himself an assist, and he's been doing a lot of positive things out there for the Rögle BK, a team that I very much like, not just because of Moritz Seider, but because of my Nils Höglander on the Vancouver fandom also playing there too. Joe Veleno having a little bit of a tough time, but hey, growing pains. He's got a few more weeks to go before the NHL comes back, and he'll be recalled over to play in the AHL, if the AHL even does exist, next season. But as for Jonatan Berggren, hey, not surprising, the guy's doing really well. So talk to me in the comments what you think about all three of these Detroit Red Wings prospects, some dominating the SHL, others having a little bit of a tough time, but I want to hear your thoughts in the comments below. Regardless, I hope you enjoyed this video. Show that Trolls 99, and bye.